Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I've got a flat icon tutorial for you in Adobe Illustrator. So let's go ahead and get started. This is the image we're going to make. And first, we'll want to draw this shape. So I'm going to go ahead and get started with that circle. So let's hit L to get our circle tool. I'll hold Option and Shift. That way it goes straight from the middle. And then we can choose orange. Now I'm going to go to Appearance and add a stroke to this. Let's add a 5-point stroke. Now I want to add another stroke behind this one. I'm going to take this stroke and duplicate it like this. I'm going to pull that below the fill. Well, I thought it was. There we go. And let's change that to blue. And now we can make it quite a lot bigger. I'll make it 33. Okay, now I need one more stroke. Right now we've got orange, white, blue, white. So we want the same thing here. Orange, white, blue, and white. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy this blue stroke by holding it and dragging it down here to new stroke. And let's add 5 to this. So it'll be the same width as this stroke up here. So it'll be 39. And we'll change it to white. All right. Now I'm going to go ahead and draw a new circle because I would just use this same circle, but as you can see, that circle is not in line with this circle. It's a little higher up. So I want to just make a new one. It'll be the easiest. With my L tool, I'll hold Shift and Option and draw the bigger circle. Hit X to move your fill in front and then click green. And then Shift Command left bracket to send to back. Now this doesn't look quite the same, so I'm gonna click back on my orange circle. And it looks like, oh, I see what's wrong. This stroke is on top of the orange fill. So we see all 5 pixels of it. Let me zoom in a little bit here. We see all 5 pixels, but this stroke is underneath the blue fill. So we're actually only seeing 2.5. The other 2.5 is behind that blue fill. So we have to add 10 instead of 5 here to see all 10 or all 5 pixels. So I'll go ahead and put 44. And now you can see they're the same size. Okay, and I command minus to zoom back out. To get the beveled edge around the ribbon top, we'll have to kind of separate these. There's probably a way to do it within Appearance, but I couldn't get it to work quite right. It just looks kind of more like a flower scallop than this type of scallop. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this, paste in front, which is Command F, and then I'm going to expand, which is Command E, and then Shift Command E is Expand Appearance. And I'll do that again, Command E, to get the actual pieces of it. And now all I want really is this outer edge. So with my G tool, hold Shift and click right on that line. You have to be on the very edge of it. And that will select everything but that edge. Now, what we have now is a fill, only a fill. So we want this to be only a stroke. To do that, to switch these without hitting this, you can hit Shift X. And it will switch them. Let's go ahead and make that 5 now. And here's where I'm going to add the scallop. Go to Effect, Distort and Transform, Zig Zag. And we will push Preview. I want it to be a smooth edge. Let's get that size down to something a little more manageable. But maybe a few more ridges per segment. Okay, something like this. Maybe 0.05. Now, as you can see, we're getting a little closer to this. Maybe we'll do a few less segments. Go back to the Appearance, click Zigzag here, and then we'll do 6. Okay, and I think that's pretty close. Now, hide that with Command 3. Let's go ahead and make this white part blue. So I'll click that stroke down there in my Appearance palette and click blue. And now I'll unhide. That's Option Command 3. Okay, we are almost there. I'm going to make this circle. I want to make sure that no parts of the blue are bleeding out. So let's go and zoom in with Z. And it looks like we're gonna have an issue here. Now, let's get rid of this blue. Sometimes I would have built it this way from the get-go, but I wanted to show you some of the things that can happen when you're building. So you just have to kind of make it work as you go. Undo, work backwards if you need to. So let's go ahead and delete that stroke. And delete that stroke. So now we've got something similar to our little guy over here. Now, as far as these little tassels, I'm going to hit M for the rectangle tool and draw a little rectangle. And we want it to have a blue fill. I just switched these by hitting X. Have a blue fill and a white outline, which is fine. And I'm going to add anchor points now. To do that, you go to Object, Path, Add Anchor Points. And that will add an extra anchor point between every existing anchor point. Now with your A tool, draw a little rectangle around the middle and left part of that. And now I'll arrow in. Okay, and you can hold Shift arrow and go a little further. Let's take this whole shape with your V tool and warp it. Go to Effect, Warp, and Arc. Probably, well, let's try Arch. Now the bend should be a negative number because we want it to curve downward like this. So I'm gonna hit Preview. And that's pretty close to what we want. Maybe not quite as drastic. We'll do -5. Okay. And if I turn this now, I'll show you what happens. It changes the warp. Now the warp is here instead of on this edge. So we have to expand this. Command E or Shift Command E for expand appearance. If you don't have expand appearance set up, I would recommend doing that. That's under Edit, Keyboard Shortcuts. It will be under your menu commands, Objects, and then Expand Appearance. I've got mine set to Shift Command E, but I don't think that's normal. I don't think it actually comes with a key command here, but I always add one because I use it all the time. Go ahead and set it up here. You can set it to whatever you want. Okay, so we've expanded this, and now let's rotate with the R tool. And then with V, we'll move it up where it should go. Command Copy, and then paste in front, Command F. Then I'm going to hit O, return, and then make sure vertical is clicked here and say okay. And then we'll just slide this over, hit V, hold shift while you're sliding and it should move it exactly over. Now I'm going to select this, this, and the circle and send all of those to the back. Shift command left bracket. I'm going to set these two as one piece by grouping them. That's command G. Now I'll take everything and align it and it should look good. Don't look quite as cute, and I think the reason is because we don't have rounded corners. So let's go to stroke, and then for the cap and corner, I'll put both on the middle, and you can see the little cute rounded edge. And to match it up, let's move these up a little bit. I'm holding shift and using my arrow keys. I'll move them over. Well, actually, they're probably centered perfectly. Should leave them alone. Let's get the star. So go underneath your rectangle tool, all the way to the star tool, and try to get it in the, as close to the center. You can always center it up with the align tool, but hold option, shift, and then draw the star. If you like this kind of star, hold down option while you draw. But if you like the kind of star that looks more like this, which is sort of a kind of fatter star, then don't hold option when you use the star tool. Okay, let's delete that. Now we want this to just have a white fill. I'm going to switch these by hitting Shift X, and then I'll hit X to bring the stroke to the front and then clear it with the question mark key. Okay, so we've got a little star. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger by holding Shift and Option while pulling a corner, and I'll align again. Let's lock this green part. I'm going to lock with Command 2. And now these things can be selected, but not the green circle in the background. The way I usually make these, I'll make a few different copies of this graphic and then send some to the right and kind of manipulate them that way. Okay, now I want to make three copies of this total. So first off, you want to make sure to group this. Command G. Now let's make our copies. I'm going to copy it, clear, which is Shift Command A, and then paste in front, Command F. And then I'm going to clear that, Shift Command A, and paste in front again. This last copy, I'm going to send to the right 10 inches. So I'll hit V, return, 10 inches horizontal, 0 vertical, and say OK. And now if we go over here, I'm going to zoom out. We can see that copy, which is exactly 10 inches over right now. Zooming back in, I have two copies left here, and I'm going to take the top one, hold shift, and drag it down 45 degrees. See how it stays on that 45 if you hold shift? So now we have two copies of this guy. At this point, it's probably best to go ahead and completely expand it out. So let's do that. It's Shift Command E for expand appearance, then Command E for expand. And that looks like it pretty well got it. Let's do the same thing down here. Shift Command E, and then Command E for expand. And I'm going to go ahead and Pathfinder unite these. That's the first one under the shape modes. Now let's change the color just so you guys can see what's going on. And I'll do the same here. And I will use the same color over here. Okay, actually let's use a darker green color, because that's what color it's going to end up as anyway. Now, I just want to get this line, these lines. So what you want to do, you want to look for the outermost edge if you're coming at a 45 degree angle, which is probably right here. Once you find that, you want to click right on the edge of it and drag, holding your shift key. You can grab a point, but be careful about that because you don't want to grab, for example, if I grab this one, then it moves that part over, and we don't want that. If anything, grab below that farthest point. Okay, so I grabbed that and brought it down, and now it's overlapping this one down here, and I want to do the same thing over here. I'm going to grab the point below the farthest point out, hold shift, and drag it out to meet that other one. It has to overlap this other one. That's very important. So let's select both now, and we will unite these two shapes. And now with your G tool, that's the direct selection, and that is another key command you'll need to set up in the tools part of keyboard shortcuts. I call it the G tool. Hold shift and click on the very edge of this. You have to get right on the edge and then hit delete. So now we have a solid shape here. And as you can see, it looks a lot like this one. So that is great. Now I want to cut it to the circle. So I'm going to grab the background circle, copy that, clear, which is Shift Command A, paste in front, and then I don't want a fill or a stroke on this. So I've got my fill in front, and I'm going to hit question mark to clear it. We've got this shape, and now I'm going to go ahead and hold shift and click the other shape. And we will divide this time. Okay, now hold shift, and with your G or A, click in the middle here. So now that's deselected, but everything else is still selected, and then just hit delete. So now we have just our shape. If we want it to look like this one, I usually use a dark gray, and then I'll set it to about 50% and multiply here. And that gives us a good shadow, and it's nice because you can put that same gray on several colors and it will still look just a shade darker than whatever it's sitting on top of. Let's grab this shape, hit V, return, and then minus 10 and 0. That sends it exactly back. Zoom in, and you can see it's kind of gray. That's because it's actually behind that shadow right now. So hit Shift Command right bracket to bring it to the front, And there you have it, a nearly identical image of this ribbon over here. Please let me know if you have any questions or comments. This is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and I hope you enjoy my tutorial today. Please click like if you like this and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Thank you.